Stanford University.
We decided on thin film panels. It's photovoltaic, and it's basically producing voltage from the sun and actually providing a DC current into the house. You then take that and transform it to AC current for all your appliances. And with an on-the-grid system like our house, you're actually selling electricity back to the grid. And then the great thing about it is that you produce the most PV energy, photovoltaic energy, during the day when the sun's out. And that's actually when you would pay the most for it from an electric company. And so you're selling it back at those critical peak demand times, reducing the overall load on the system. We decided to go with thin film. We liked that it was a pretty new technology that's actually getting better and better. There's a lot of great things about it. First, it's a lot cheaper than monocrystalline. And it's also uses a lot less material. It's just a thin sheet of glass and then the semiconductor layer. And so we really like that about these panels. Also, we went with a local company called Stion. They're based in San Jose. It's actually all Stanford grads. So it was nice to sort of see an emerging technology from Stanford that we can then use again on a Stanford project. The cost of PV is going down significantly from just the way it's being built. But the labor to install it is still one of the biggest barriers to entry because it's still a pretty technical and intensive process. So we're looking at ways to sort of reduce that time. And one of the ways to do that is to make the roof more accessible for solar PV. So we're using a standing seam sheet metal roof, and it has these ridges in it so that you can actually use these clip products and just attach the PV panels to the roof. So that really reduces the amount of time it takes to install these PVs, and it's one of those important factors to making PV more accessible to everyone. The most important thing when you're designing a net zero house, we discovered, is actually to reduce the amount of electricity to begin with. And that started with really carefully designing a house that was passively heated and cooled, that got a lot of natural daylight, so you didn't need light bulbs throughout the day, and then just a lot of different design techniques. Then it took a lot of careful estimation from our engineering team to try to figure out how much on a daily basis our house would actually consume. Once you install those panels, you shouldn't have to pay for electricity ever.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.